Inspiration Nation. Hello, Lee Kemp here for another week on the podcast, as always, with both Ryan and Joe. How are we doing, guys?
Good, thank you.
Yeah, we're good. Thanks, Lee. I'm going to say, how are you?
Ah, I love that. It's been a while since anyone asked me that question. I'm very good as well. Thank you, Joe, for asking. Ryan, your silence is noted. Thank you, of course, everyone listening and watching. Join us on TikTok, JNoya_InspirationNation. Check him out every Tuesday as we're recording and watch live. There's a whole load of people in there now. We appreciate you for being in there. And, of course, follow us on social media at ListenToIN, ListenToIN. So, the baton is back. The baton of conversation. Which direction am I putting it this week, guys?
Well, it was my week last week, right?
It was.
And I did the week before. It was just okay. Joe and I.
So by the process of elimination, it must be my week. I had something ready to go that I want to do, but actually I thought it might be my week this week, and I'm going to do something different that I thought today. So in our preamble we talked before, Joe and Ryan, I am working somewhere different today. I'm in my happy place. I have a place by the sea to get away to at the weekend, so I'm working to in the week as well. So my subject for this week is, where is your happy place?
Oh, I like that. Okay. Nice.
And it can be a literal place. It can be a state of mind. It can be anything in between.
Okay. I'm going to lead on this.
Oh, look at that. Ryan's keen. Go.
I'm going to challenge, say, I don't have one.
Okay.
Now, when I was younger, and I still do play a lot of pool and things like that. But when I was younger, I used to maybe on a Friday evening or a Saturday evening, if I had no plans, I would go and play pool for 2-3 hours, take some headphones, put some music on and just disappear. I might play snooker or whatever as well. It was interchangeable. And I used to, the word isn't fool myself, but fool myself into thinking that was my happy place and that was what I needed to cheer myself up. But the truth is, I was never unhappy in the first place to need a happy place. And I never left there happier than when I joined there. So I got quickly kind of diverted off of that as an ideal. I stand by it. I compartmentalize really well. Like, if I have a bad day at work, I can just log off and that would be that. If I hear some bad news, I can process it and then I can generally move on quite well, generally speaking. So I don't think I've ever needed one to have one, if that makes sense.
So my counter question is, do you need one to have one? Because I think you're right. I don't think it denotes that you're unhappy everywhere else. But is there something, you know, does it enhance things? Is it multiple things? Is it 10 different places during the day that you bounce from one to the other?
No, I don't think so. I don't think so because I don't feel like I've ever had to try and really find one. I went to find one years ago, as I say, because I thought everyone had to have one. I thought that was just the, you know, part and parcel of life. But when I found that my favorite hobby and the thing I love doing the most didn't make me feel any happier than when I walked in, and by the same token didn't make me feel any less happier than when I walked in, then did I really need one? And since then I've stopped looking, and perhaps I'm constantly in my happy place, if you like, as logic dictate, because I'd never leave it. I don't know.
What do you think, Jose?
Yeah, I'm really struggling with this one because I'm just thinking, have I got in a happy place? I don't think I have. Like a place where I'm thinking of a happy place, and this is what I'm thinking, is that I have somewhere I go and it's a place where I go and I get away from everything and I'm happy. That's what I'm thinking. Is that what we're sort of, how we're framing it?
I don't think it has to be that, no. And okay. I think that's a misinterpretation from people. And I'll give you a few examples
okay.
to put some context on it, I suppose. So I had a, this is years ago now, like in another lifetime for me, but I had a situation where I lived somewhere and it all got a bit nasty with the landlord and it became very stressful and moved away from that place and it wasn't good. And for a while afterwards, I felt a bit uncomfortable, shall we say. It was in a small place. I was worried I might bump into people. All wasn't very nice. I just wanted to get away from it all. And really randomly, new place that I lived had a standalone shower. And I got in the shower. And the smell of the water reminded me of the smell of the showers at a place where I used to go on family holidays where I was a kid. And it was just really comforting. And while all this was going on that felt bruh, that was while I was, it was almost like I was safe when I was there because it took my mind to a place that I thought about that. And it's, you know, as with everything, you know, you move on, things change. It soon became, or anything that's going on soon became a non-issue. But at the time, that kind of safe space, something that helped with getting through that initial bit. And I think that is where it becomes an escapism thing. On the other end of the spectrum now, I don't think I've unhappy place. I spend most of my days working from home from an office job. I absolutely love that. We've talked about that loads over the podcast. Such like tomorrow, I'm working in an office. I'm going to get to see a few people. I'm looking forward to doing that. I have where I am now that we come down to the weekends, which is nice and relaxing and getting away from things. But also on a smaller level, we've talked about before, there's a number of podcasts I like to listen to. So in the mornings, part of my morning routine, makes Joe very happy that I have a morning routine, is that I have a number of things I look to do and I will stick my podcast on and I will do those things. And the things almost become background noise to me listening to my podcast. And that's just a really nice way to, in fact, I book in because I start the day like that and then I end the day like that, like having it on while I'm making dinner and stuff like that. And all of those places are little versions of that, I think, where I feel quite good in all of them. But they're different flavours to it. So the podcast is a good way to relax and wind and get to listen to things I want to listen to, enjoy what I do for work, which I'm just lucky in doing. But then like where I am now, where we come away to, it's a different space where actually phones, gaming, jobs I've got to do in the house, all that, which again, none of those are bad things, but all that goes away and it's a bit of a disconnect from the world and a proper chill out place that I didn't, it's not like I was yearning for it before I had it, but it's like an enhancement. So it's not a, oh, I need it to decompress or de-stress or everything else is awful except for this 5 minutes that I'm here. Because I think I talked about before, people who live for these really short periods of time have probably got the wrong balance going on. But I think there's that for me, and it's over time, it's spread more and more and more that I'm very conscious of the things I enjoy doing and positivity in my environment. And I think I'm, you know, getting to a stage where I'm building that everywhere I am. I'm kind of very conscious of that, if you like. So there's, and this is why I say it doesn't physically have to be a place. It can also be a mindset, because the podcast thing I can do literally anywhere I am, but it's a very defined thing for me that it has a feeling to it no matter where I do it.
Yeah, well, it does make a lot of sense that, because I was thinking when you were saying the question and when Ryan was talking, I think, yeah, do I have one? I'm not quite sure. And yeah, so for me, I've written a couple of things down, because when you're all talking, I was trying to, it's a little blend for me. So I have routines. So I don't necessarily have a place where I go to and it's happy. Like I say, for me, it's my routines. Like I'll get up and I'll do
I like that. That.
I'll get up and, you know, the routine is probably the thing that is my state. I get into a state. So a state when I mean, like when I'm releasing content or thinking about, you know, things about, you know, about how I can take steps towards the dream, right? Like creating content and helping people. I get into a state of flow, and that is probably my happy place when I'm just focused on that thing. I'm not thinking about anything else. Or I may have a meditation and I'm just trying to meditate and just take, I'm like almost like my mentality is like somewhere else, but I'm just me. I'm not, like you say, I'm not thinking about DIY. I'm not thinking about this. I'm just in that state and I'm just focused in that state. That's probably where my happy place is. But at the same time, I do have a dream, which I think I'd love to create. I'd love to create a happy place. Like I went to Cornwall lately and there's a place called St. Ives. I'd love to have a place there to go to, or a place abroad where I could just go to, or a place like what you got in your place, like a place to go to, which is away. So I think an enhancement with that would be lovely. Like a, almost like a little retreat or something. That would be the dream. So I think I've got work to do in regards to that. So my happy place is is the stuff that makes me feel that I'm in flow. I'm not thinking about things like if I meditate and if I'm doing things that I'm working on my dream and I'm in a place where I'm enjoying it. Actually playing tennis, which I do now when I play, that creates that state where I'm just enjoying the playing of the tennis and I'm not thinking about anything else. So can I call that my happy place? Where
without question, yeah.
I'm not saying it's happy. I suppose what's happiness? I think, how do we define happiness? Happiness is a place where we are in a place of state, in place of where we are, we're there and we're living and we feel we're, I suppose, just living in a place of great joy, right?
Where are you most in the moment? And I don't think it's, yeah, I don't think it's, oh, you've got a massive grin on your face and every worry you've ever had has gone away and stuff like that. But where can you most be in that kind of mindful, in the moment, content with yourself type of place? And like I said, that place could be a physical place or a state of mind you could do anywhere, or a combination of the two, that the place helps you bring the state of mind, for example. It could be any of those things, I think. But I don't think it's physically an escapism place. It's more, what is it for you? Where mentally do you click into that zone?
Oh yeah, so based on that, and I think it's both though. I think you can create places, and I think it is that. I think the first step though, for me personally, is the mental state, and then enhancing it with what you're saying about maybe having a space. My sister has a meditation room, you know, which is created.
I was going to say you could do a room or even a corner of a room, anything like that, or a spot in the garden. There's all these things that can, you know, like I said with the shower thing, there's a sensory thing that can help trigger all of that as well.
Yeah, so I just want to give a little shout out, actually, because I want to make sure we bring TikTok into the conversation. So Rick Grimes is here, regular to the live shows, the regular to my lives I do on TikTok. So welcome, Rick. Appreciate you sending likes away, which is fantastic. And also, please TikTok, please ask questions, and I'll try and raise them to the guys. So if you've got questions at the minute, what we're talking about is, where is your happy place? And it could be a place you go, or it could be a state of mind that you apply, where you feel in the moment. That's what Lee's been raising. It's Lee's subject today. So yeah, so if you feel free, I'll try and pick up some questions. But yeah, back over to you, Lee and Ryan, to add to the conversation. But yeah, so it's great. Welcome, guys. Appreciate you.
What about you, Lee? Like, you've suggested that in the same way you have your podcast and things like that, has yours ever, and you know, you mentioned your shower situation, but where, I say, what about you in the sense that where's this come from? Have you had to think of a new one? Have you developed a new one that perhaps you've not mentioned?
No, I think I've obviously, as we know, there's always a layer of mindfulness to my conversation topics at the moment. It's something I'm conscious of, if you like, of the importance of getting better. And I do, sometimes I will start worrying about things into the future, and I will draw myself back into be in the moment. So there is definitely something there where I'm catching myself, because I can do that, and I you know, especially when I was a lot younger, I do it all the time, and I look back and I think I could do more of this practice now. So I'm always aware on it. But no, it just came from, actually, I'm on a, where I am at the moment, there's like a Facebook group for the people that are here, and lots of people have just started referring to that term recently, and it just kind of stuck in my mind. And then, as you do, wander around thinking, I thought, oh, that might be a good discussion point. And it started to get me just thinking a bit about what that term means, and your mind runs away of itself and all that. So that's where it came from. It kind of got implanted just reading it a few times and then thinking, oh, what does that really mean?
Yeah. And I think that it means different things to different people, doesn't it?
100%.
It's a real perspective. I've actually got a question from Rick. Says, why would you go to your happy place? So I suppose, Rick, are we talking about why? You know, I suppose, I'm just going to pass the question, pass it over to you guys. Why would you go to your happy place? Is there a specific reason?
I think it's a good framing device for mindfulness and, you know, contentment and being in the moment and stuff. And it's not like with what I do, same as yours, Joe. There's certain things in my routine that are things that I like and make me feel calm and content and et cetera, et cetera. And I think it's just a consciousness to build in as much of that to your day as you can. So not that it's almost like there's a build up to then getting to it, but you start, I think what's important and part of the message for me today is about just making that part of your, as much as possible, as part of your everyday life as you can. Find out, you know, be consciously aware of those things and kind of dial those up and other things down. Again, more for that, you know, sense of well-being and everything with people. So yeah, I don't think it's as much as than this. Again, this is why I don't think that, back to what I said to Ryan at the start, it's not about a need for having one. It's more about the importance of the wellness factor of it.
Oh, it's good. Yeah. 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 I mean, for me, I think, you know, and it's funny you saying that, because I was watching something by Ray Dalio this week, and I think I posted it in our Inspiration Nation chat about, he was talking about world order, and a bit, you know, it's not about meditation, but Ray Dalio, he's a real hedge fund manager. If you look him up on YouTube, massive hedge, like, you can't get to his hedge fund now, he's so massive. But he uses meditation, and imagine he could buy any happy place, but he's got his place where he still feels like he's going on holiday. He uses meditation, and this is a guy who's a multi-billionaire, and this is, for meditation for him is his like happy place. It's like where he can go and feels like he's going on holiday, and you can imagine what he could probably buy, right? He could probably buy an island, right? And but he doesn't. And so, you know, going from that type of thing, I think that's what I try and do. If I feel like, so ask Rick's question about why, is if I'm feeling like I'm on the treadmill, like I'm and everything's out, I will try and unplug and meditate and try and do something that unplugs me from everything. I'm probably a bit like you go off to your place, Lee, I don't know. But that's what I do, is I tend to go, I need some space for me, and my space for me will be unplugged from harmony, everything, just to be on my own, which I never used to do. And I think that's something I've learned to do, to try and be on my own a bit more, is to have that meditative practice. And it could only be for 5 to 10 minutes, it doesn't have to be long, but 5 to 10 minutes of practice just helps me unplug and just stop all the to-dos. There's always something to do, right? It's always something to do.
Always.
You know, and it's crazy, isn't it? We tend to go on that treadmill, but just getting off that treadmill just for 5 or 10 minutes, just to give your mind some peace and to quiet your mind down, gives you that some energy. And am I right, guys? Can you just tell me if I'm right, whether there's any research to say, what is the organ in the body which takes up the most energy? Is it the brain, right? Is they say that? I'm not quite sure if I've got that right, but I'm sure I've heard somewhere that it takes up the most energy, right? Sorry?
I think you are right about that, yes.
Yeah. But I was going to throw over to Ryan, actually. Ryan, what about you? You know, you say you haven't got one. Is now hearing this conversation, do you think, where do you think your happy place is now? How you said that, you know, you said you didn't have one, but what would you think now?
Still feel the same. I don't know if that's a bad thing or not, but I don't think there's anything in my life right now, and I'm very lucky to say, I don't think there's anything in my life that causes me to need one. And I know we're saying about you don't need to have, but because I don't need one, I haven't gone looking for one. So, you know, to me, I feel the same, and I don't know if that's a bad thing. I don't know if that's something that maybe I should look at or look into, but there isn't really a part of my day that I struggle with. There are bits that are more testing than others, but I think a lot of people would say that, right? Similarly to Lee, I enjoy the job that I do. I enjoy, for the most part, the industry that we work in. I finish work. I do things that I enjoy, whether that's playing video games, watching television, seeing family, friends, going to the pub. I come home, and then the best part of the day is going to sleep, isn't it, after a nice day. You lay down and you go to sleep. To me, and don't get me wrong, there's different parameters around that, but the long and short of it is that's what I do. And I'm very lucky to say that I don't have that much responsibility to test me. You know, I don't have young kids or youngish kids that test my, not happiness, that's the wrong word, but my patience. And I'm sure most parents will say, I don't have a relationship with a loved one that means that I need to devote time and energy into that, to need a break from that. Perhaps maybe you guys might at some point in your lives. I don't do a job that makes me want to pull my hair out, for the most part, but I don't feel like I need that time away. I'm always doing things that I enjoy. Do I procrastinate and do things I enjoy less at the last minute? Of course. But I think everyone does that. That doesn't necessarily mean that I need a safe space or a happy place to go off to. What the conversation has led me to think is, you know, do I need one? Do I need to go away now and think about what makes me happy or where makes me happy, and devote a section of time, a day, a week, a month, a quarter, a year, to be able to keep myself happy? Perhaps. Perhaps. I don't know.
Well, that's got to be
the question, Ryan, because there's still an angle on this that I'm a bit uncomfortable with in the message, which is I don't see it as an escape. For me, there isn't a part in what I do day to day that I'm like, oh, I've just got to get away from that and get to X. It's not a coping mechanism away from things.
Sure.
So, and on the flip, what I'd say is on the flip side of it, if you're saying you don't have one, does that mean you just go through every day being neither happy nor unhappy? You're just in a state of
maybe. I mean, neutrality. We've spoken before where I've said I don't feel like I feel emotion, right? I think we've said before I've go through days where I just am what I am. I don't really go through that cycle of emotion realistically. Maybe that's a contributing factor. Perhaps. I don't know. Maybe it's something I need to look at myself. Maybe there's things I need to look into, you know?
I don't think that's a bad thing. I think it's a good thing to think, oh, maybe something that could bring to your awareness that you might want to be considering. I think it's a great thing. I think it's,
and
especially when we're tested, because I know not long ago you're being tested quite severely, not long ago, really tested, and you're dealing with it, but it was testing, right?
Yeah. But it wasn't something I didn't enjoy.
No.
Just to jump in there. I enjoyed that test. Whether that test was perhaps testing of me is a different question, but it wasn't something that I hated and felt that I needed to find a happy place to rebalance my mental state. I didn't feel like that. I just felt like it was a challenge that I needed to overcome. Maybe that's my I want to say winner's mentality. That's the wrong word, but maybe that's my pride mentality of wanting to really succeed. And that makes me happy. Feeding that part of my ego makes me happy as well. So I don't, maybe I'm approaching it in the wrong way. I'm not sure.
There's no wrong way. I don't think it's a personal way, isn't it? I don't think there's any wrong way. So Ryan, don't think it's the wrong way. It's the right, it's whatever works for the individual, which is right. That's what this whole conversation I feel is about from my perspective, is whatever works for the individual. So, you know, I think it's not a right or wrong. It's I think what I like about it is that it provokes thought about, actually, do I need one? What is it? How can I improve it? What can I improve on what I'm doing right now? I think that's a really good question. You know, is there something I need to bring in that could make it even better? I'm okay, but how could I make it that little bit better? I think that's probably what I'm coming at it from, that angle. I'm okay now, but how could I improve my meditation? How could I improve a happy place? Could I start having a goal towards maybe a place where I could, you know, relax more, or, you know, like my tennis, can I enhance that more? And you know, all that sort of stuff. Just want to give a couple of shouts out. So Paloma, thank you for coming back to the live. Thank you, Shang, for following on TikTok. That's joining our 10,000 followers. So thank you for joining my journey. And thank you, Jack, for come back to the live. Appreciate you. So Jack is one that comes back a lot, so I just want to give him shout outs, but there you go. Really appreciate the lives, guys. So thank you so much for commenting. I am trying to stay engaged with the comments, but we're gonna have this podcast, so there you go. Yeah, over to you guys. Sorry about that. I just wanted to just like shout out on TikTok.
If I've missed the point of your subject, Lee, then I apologize. That isn't my intention, but I feel like you're perhaps not satisfied with my position.
No, I just, well, like you said, something to look at. I think you've touched on it. I think you listed off when you talked about your day a lot of things you do that you do because you enjoy them. And I suppose I would question whether or not that is part of what is that happy place.
Yeah, I think I touched on it earlier when I said maybe I never leave the happy place to need a happy place.
Exactly, 100% that, I think. But that, and again, it's back to, and I think it is a key message for me, because it's not a negative thing in that, oh, everything's terrible, I've got to get away. I don't think that's how people should look at it. It's not like you've got to have something bad to then have something good. You could, like you're saying, Ryan, you could always perpetually live in or intend to be in that place. And I think the more you're conscious of it, the more you can enhance that. Like you said, Joe, with focus on the meditation or the tennis and stuff like that. I think that, again, for very much like they talk about with doctor, I remember there's talk, it might not be now, but it used to be all the time that what we should focus on physically is wellness, not treatment. You know, let's make sure we never get to that state where we need treatment. I think it's the same for your mental health, is don't wait for something bad to happen to need to get out of it, you know, or just work on making, you know, your wellness points or bucket or whatever better and better and better and more full as much as you can.
Well, yeah, absolutely. Case in point, you know, my depression you know, is the case that I wasn't aware of that. And I think that's an important thing to sort of shout out here, is that what you're saying around, you know, for some of us, it might be that we're in a good state, you know, and we can manage that. For others, it's going to be, they're going to get something hard hit them, right? You know, someone's going to hit you hard from life, and having some resilience or something, some tool or something you can use to help you get through that, that's helpful. Like, you know, creating a happy place. Maybe it's a book, maybe it's a podcast like you do. Maybe it's, you know, whatever it is to get you through, I think it's important. So we're all going to, we've had three different perspectives here, haven't we? We'd have, you know, Ryan, where you've got a lot pretty constant, you have some ups and downs, but you see it as a challenge. You've got Lee, you've got, you know, you have your, I think the smell of the water and stuff that remind you of your happy place. And they've enhanced it with, you know, a whole, you know, this lovely place you've got where you are. And for me, I've got my meditation and tools. So we've got three sort of different perspectives that we use, but I don't, you know, and I think we can all enhance it. I think the message is people can enhance it and prepare for those things, because life, we know life's going to come at us, don't we? We all know that there's more challenges around the corner. And I think that preparation, and I think having a, whatever our version of a happy place is, having in a happy place is going to be important for when those times come, because they will come. But how each and every one of us can have something that can build in that resilience, so we can get through it, so we can continue to live a life that we can enjoy. So that's my take on it. But yeah, I like that. It's very, very good. Thank you, Lee and Ryan, for your perspective. Really enjoyed that.
My closing thought on it is as well, and again, you know, advice for people looking to do it, is you can make it a shared experience as well. So there's some of those happy places for me are with, you know, with other people. And a little small one is the, you know, end of every day, me and my half, we'll get into bed, we'll watch some TV before we fall asleep. And there's always something for me that's quite comforting about the fact that no matter what happens, every day ends like that, in that position together doing that, or even just, you know, TV shows we watch together, or spending time with the kids, or things like that. There's all those things which I think you can frame that device of, you know, happy place. How often does it happen? How do you do it? I think there's a lot of, like you said, Joe, a lot of different lenses and a lot of different interpretation on it. And like a lot of these things, I think I like to bring up, it's just these concepts to think about, to take things you probably do day to day without even thinking about it, and becoming conscious of it and turning that into a tool to help yourself.
Yeah, I definitely agree with that. I think it's all about what works for you. And I think you and we talk 100%. About your way of life, you know, this is a thought-provoking podcast. It's provoking a thought that could create change, that could help you just be that, you know, just help you live life better, right? Because we all want that. We all want to have a, you know, always want to see that if there's, we can have that small improvement. And this is one of those things I think is a really great thing to be thinking about, because I've never really thought of the happy place. What is the happy place? You know, what is my happy place? You know, it's made me think about it more deeper. And what do I do that makes me happy? You know, it makes it, oh, maybe I do this. That makes me feel a bit better. But is that happy? Is it satisfying? Can I enhance it? And I think, you know, having Ryan's perspective, your perspective, and, you know, and things like that, then, you know, that's what it's about, right? Thank you.
Oh, I've never got a thank you for a topic before. I like that.
I just think it's made me think differently. I think it's just given me some food for thought, you know, to enhance things. And enhancement's always good. I always like things that can make that 0.1 or 1% better. So if I can do that, then great.
Right, so I'll do some shilling.
Go on then. Do your shilling.
Yes. Thank you, everyone, again. Follow us on social media at listen to IN. Obviously, check out Joe. Just put Jose Noy Inspiration Nation in that search engine. Joe is everywhere. And join us on TikTok, JNoya_Inspiration Nation. Follow Joe on that journey to 10,000. Get great videos from Joe every single day. And of course, you can get the podcast live and early, and even interact with us as people have done today. Check out Joe, we'll signpost when we're going live. It's always around about 6-ish on a Tuesday, unless we decide to do it another week or another time. But we try and be as stuck to that routine as we can. And of course, check out inspirationnation.org.uk. Everything through the podcast, archive of shows, sign up for the newsletter, get your T-shirts and mugs and whatever else. I have nothing with me today, I'm afraid. Look at that. Joe is rocking a T-shirt, though. Love to see it. Help support the nation. He is all over the merch.
I've got the merch out today.
As always, guys, thank you for your input on this. It's been really good, and good to get different perspectives on everything as well. And Ryan, I just qualify, I was in no way unsatisfied with what you said. I just think you're more in that place than you give yourself credit for.
I don't like leaving people unsatisfied, mate. You know how it is.
But Ryan, look, this is not about people pleasing. This is about you. So you don't have to get Lee's approval.
Lee's my dad. I've always got to please him.
Well, that's a rumor that's going out right now, isn't it? That's great. That's going to be this going through his whole podcast, isn't it?
I look far too young to be his dad. Some would suggest we might even be brothers. In fact,
Well, I'm not sure about that, actually, Lee. I'm not sure. We'll see, you know. But now you've grown the beard, of course, you know.
Let me do the maths. Oh, yeah, no, it's fine. It's good. I'm good.
But you would have had to have been an early bloomer. I think that's the long and short of that statement.
Right, I feel like we should draw a line on this conversation and I'll count us down.
Go on, then.
Oh, 3, 2, 1. Inspiration Nation. Catch you guys later.
Let me know what your biggest takeaway is from this conversation. I'd love to know. Put it in the comments below and I'll respond to every single comment because that's a commitment I make to you in this community. Also, don't forget to subscribe right over here because we need you to build this Inspiration Nation community, to get the podcast out there and to help other people for free. And also, don't forget to hit that bell right over here because if you hit that bell, then you're going to know when another videos go live. And don't forget to check out these videos right here next to me, because those other podcast episodes that can really help you out, I really, really appreciate it. And lastly, don't forget out to check the newsletter. The link is in the description below. That's where I can talk directly to you without through the YouTube, throughout the social, because you can have a direct communication channel with me through the email and you can get to know everything that's going on with Inspiration Nation, ask me questions and even give me suggestions on what you'd want us to talk about next. So I'd love to see you in the next video. So please click on those links. Please follow through. Please let's get this community building. I appreciate you. So until next time, I'll see you in the next video. Inspiration Nation, and I'll catch you guys later.